Thank you, my dear. Yes, children. So we are discussing regarding non-tariff barrier. Once upon a time, there was a king. Like that we were discussing. Now you are back to Pavilion. So you have to be more attentive and you have to be more responsible enough. Idhar udhar dekhkar baithna ka nahi chahiye. So non-tariff barrier mein what all things are included, you can see there. That's the main thing, whether it is objective or descriptive, this area is very important. You can see here, import quotas, dekho, import license, voluntary export restrictions, product standard, these are the non-tariff barrier. Question kaisa aayega, which one of the following is not a non-tariff barrier? Like that question will come. So you, yes, whoever is talking directly will be out. Yes, look here. So what is quota? What is import license? What is voluntary export restrictions? We are going to discuss. Children, today's newspaper is important from two point of view. Yesterday, economic survey was tabled in the parliament. And today, all the newspapers are having economic survey. So all of you must read it. The question arises, what is economic survey? Economic survey is the white paper on the health of the economy of the last year and how the economy will go in this year. In that, what is the GDP growth rate? What is the saving? What was the investment? Everything. It is just like a health report of the individual. It is a health report of the economy. Today, 11 o'clock is the budget presentation. Nirmala Sitharaman is going to announce the fourth budget. Okay. This budget is I'm sorry. This budget is very crucial because one is you are aware that many state governments are going for election. Another point is economy is still not fully recovered from the COVID effects. So the point of discussion is listen to the budget speech. Read about the budget. I told you COVID ke Govandi ka konsa bhi coaching class mein ek saath baithkar exam le gaya. Okay. Nahi to coaching class wale ko 500 rupees de diya. Okay. Then also you might have somebody, not everybody is doing. But that's not going to help you at all. Please remember that. Because my base has to be very strong. In the budget, there will be discussion about foreign trade, where all these things will be discussed. Custom duty, okay, quota system. So you should know about all this. Yes. Dekho girna nahi chahiye and mai toodna bhi nahi chahiye. Both are very important. Yes, children, I am very happy to see you back. And we wish you should continue this on offline classes because this is too much. More than 2 years you are sitting at home. Yes, Reshma, you lost the link of learning the things. Okay. Now, we have discussed this part, import quota. I am quickly refreshing because very doubtful how far you are covering. 100% is not the part of the private bond. Okay, so import quota means for government put quantitative restriction on the import of a commodity. That is custom duty. Government is import, government is putting custom duty. 10%, 20%, 100%. Both of these are other. When I am importing a commodity, I will have to pay for the custom duty. Okay, that is the idea. But this is quota. Boys, quota means this is the quantitative restriction. What it means by MF. For example, if you can import only, suppose I give you a letter, I can import only up to 3 kilo of gold per year. That is quota. Many parts license over, or license be clearly over, this is the amount of gold which is allowed to be imported. That is the quota. Or I may explain the manufacturer. Suppose I am importing, I am importing cotton from outside. So there is a restriction. I can import, say for example, 10 That is the meaning of, you know, this restrictions on the quota. We are discussing import quota. Itna commodity import kar sakta hai. So there is a quota. The question is, what is the difference between tariff and quota? There are so many times students are so confused. You are much better. When you look at the employee students, you are very confused. What is the reason? 11th, they did not write the exam. 12th, they did not write the exam. Now they are in FYB without knowing what is going on happening around them. With the second bachelor, they have come to the FYB call. So that situation is really alarming situation. Compiling is a little better. At least your background is a little better than that. So when somebody is asking you, what is the difference between quota and tariff? Answer should be very clear. Tariff is the custom duty. Quota is the quantitative restriction. Take down somewhere in your book. Tariff is the custom duty. Wait. Madam is waiting. I know that taking the pen, writing, ye sab aadat hi gaya hai. So thoda time lagega. Online children, I hope I am audible. Not for you. Online children, chat box mein dalo. Can you hear? Okay. So quota means quantitative restrictions. Quantitative restrictions. Tariff means custom duty. Both are totally different. So we are discussing import quota. Okay, these are the maximum quantity of import you can see in the board. Maximum quantity of import of the commodity that are fixed by the government. So the question arises, who fixes the quota? Quota is fixed by government. Once the quota is fixed, no one can import beyond the quota. Please remember that. Because ek bar fix kar diya, that is the final. It can be changed only by the government again. These are government imposed, dekho, import restriction. Import restriction means anything which will reduce the import. That is the meaning of import restriction. Import kam karne ke liye government ne jo system accept karta hai, that is known as import restrictions. You will ask the question, madam, why the import has to be controlled? That is the main right? No problem, try to come. Import restrictions, why the government is putting restrictions on import children. If the import is too much allowed, domestic production will suffer. Suppose that government is allowing free import from China. Most of the industries in India may have to close down because China ka products are so cheap. So in order to protect the domestic industry, government is imposing the quota. Government is imposing the quota to protect the home industry. Government is imposing the quota to protect the home industry. I'm repeating, government is imposing the quota. Government is imposing the quota to restrict the or to protect the government is imposing quota to protect, restrict cut karo. To protect the home industry. To protect the home industry. You come towards the end of that particular slide. Import quota, dekho, directly reduce the quantity imported. They are more effective in reducing the deficit in the balance of payment than tariff. Suppose that there is a comparison between tariff and quota. Somebody wants to know whether tariff is more effective or quota is more effective.
I want to import. I take 30% and I import. So tariff import so effectively. But what are we doing is that we must import. And when we tell you, tariff will be over 30% tariff. And if you put a price tariff, you will be 30% your import. What are we doing?
Okay. Then there are different types of import quota from all these areas. Objectives will come. First one is tariff quota. What is the tariff quota itself? The word itself is complicated. What is tariff quota, children? Tariff quota means, you can see there, tariff is custom duty, quota is restriction. So it's a combination of both. You go there. Tariff quota means it is a combination of tariff and quota. It is a combination of tariff and quota. It is a combination of tariff and quota. दोनों का कॉम्बिनेशन है टैरिफ कोटा. हाउ इट इज वर्किंग अप देखो. अंडर दिस इंपोर्ट ऑफ ए कमोडिटी इज अलाउड अप टू स्पेसिफिक क्वांटिटी आइदर विदाउट एनी ड्यूटी और लो रेट ऑफ टैरिफ. इंपोर्ट इन एक्सेस ऑफ द कोटा, द एक्सेस ऑफ द कोटा लिमिट आर इम्पोज्ड हाई टैरिफ रेट. क्या लिखा है देखो. देयर आर टू वेज बाय विच गवर्नमेंट. Import of a commodity without, see this word, without prior negotiation with the other country, it is known as unilateral quota. What do you mean by unilateral? Ek hi side. Unilateral ka meaning hi wahi hai, single sided. So unilateral means single sided. So unilateral quota mein, what does the country do? Country imposes the quota. For your information, USA is very notorious for unilateral quota. It is today more than India is in. For example, cotton item, today import company is there. There is unilateral. But America can do that because of their economic power. But developing countries can we cannot do that. Why we cannot do that? Suppose that we are restricted fully import from China. Example. Then we are exporting.
So that is why financial quota is very unpopular. Okay. So God says that unilateral quota can be government is fixing the quota without discussing with the other country. That is the meaning of unilateral quota. So generally, whenever we are fixing the quota, always better to discuss with other country. The reason is we are restricting our import. But other export they can have the baki country can have import restricted here. So that will create some sort of discomfort in the international media. That is why unilateral quota is not a popular method. Generally countries won't accept it. I told you big, economically strong countries, they will adopt. Because usko dusre ke upar depend karne ka zarurat hai nahi. Otherwise, developing countries wo jyada nahi karega. Abhi, dekho, unilateral quota is divided into two. You can see that. That is, it may be global. You see here. It may be global or allocated quota. Yes, call that boy. Unilateral, both mushkil se, parents ke prayer ke wajah se quota chalu hua hoga. Honestly telling you. Because any parent, even you are also interested to come, I am not disputing that. Lekin parents to itana prarthana karta hoga, kaisa bhi mera bachche log normal padhai ka line par jane do. I told you mobile on karke video off karke duniya mein jo kuch karne ka hai sab kuch karega. Okay, aisa time pass karke 2 saal ho gaya abhi class mein aakar time pass karne ka nahi. Woh to bahut clear hai. Because I told you your background is very weak. You are the listening capacity, your thinking capacity, everything has been reduced. It is very natural because 2 years is a very long period. Usme se normal line mein aana, wo bhi kabhi bhi uncertainty hai. Dusra ek pharma company ne naya variant ko pakad kar media mein dala, fir again the problem will start. So we do not know how many more years we will continue with this. So literally everybody has to pray to God. Let our normal life be back. Because children, you are the one who has suffered maximum. But because the employees did not suffer, we were doing our job. But as a student, you were suffering. Because it's a human nature. Ghar mein hai apna suvidha ke anusar kaisa to bhi karega, koi dekhega nahi. Mummy ko to bolega, mummy dekho, ye to barabar listen karta hai, earphone hai. So mummy is thinking that my daughter or son is listening. Not only you, even my son was doing the same. Honestly telling you. Yes. So, but I tell the same statement to him. You are cheating to yourself. You are not cheating to anybody. Because I told you, we are really afraid how you will face tomorrow's competitive world. Your skills have disappeared. So you have to improve your skills. So you have to increase your concentration. Unilateral quota is divided into two. Dekho. One is global, other is allocated quota. What is global quota? Country may be imported from any country up to the full amount of quota limit. Underline that full amount. If you are writing down, you have to take down that. Global quota means there is a limit. We can import X amount from China. So India will import 100% that X amount. That is the global quota. Pura quota we will import. Then what about allocative quota? I will have to shift this up. Yes. Under the allocated quota, total quota limit is distributed among the specified exporting countries. See this word. Under the allocated quota, the total quota is... Oh, sorry, children, if I get up, no problem. Okay. Yeah, because while I'm getting up, I'm away from the camera. You are right. So under allocated quota,
total quota is distributed among the specified exporting country. What do you mean by that? Example, India says that all the people who are dealing with the jewelry, they can import 100 kilo of gold, but 100 kilo Australia se pura nahi ho sakega. We will divide 20 kilo from the Gulf country, 25 kilo from Australia, another 25 kilo from say Africa. Like that, alag alag country ko quota ko divide karega. That is known as allocated quota. That is much better because your relation with the other countries gets improved, because you are giving chance for other countries to import the goods to India. Global mein kya hota hai, ek hi country se pura import karega. So that is the difference between global and allocative quota. Children, global mein kya hota hai, ek hi country se hum pura import karega. Allocation mein hum divide karega. So that much we are developing good relations with the other country. That is advantage. Then bilateral quota. Bilateral quota, dekho, quotas are fixed through the negotiation. See this word. The negotiation between importing and exporting countries. This is the best one. The proper discussion happened between importing country and the exporting country. That is bilateral quota. That is the export or the commercial minister of India and the commerce minister of China. They will sit across the table and they will discuss. And they will decide. Hum India se itna import karega, then India ka minister bolega, hum aapka country se itna import karega. So that is based on proper mutual consent. That is known as bilateral quota. Discussion is happening. Bilateral means two country. Unilateral means one country. Multilateral means many country. So bilateral means two country ke beech mein agreement is happening. And proper discussion ke upar, one of the best system in the world. They are decided through mutual consent. Dekho. Therefore, there will not be any retaliation. What do you mean by retaliation? Retaliation means foreign country oppose nahi karega. That is the meaning of the term retaliation, oppose karna. Because either you are discussing and deciding, so the other country will accept it. Unilateral quota mein hum kya karta hai? We are not discussing. Hum apne aap karta hai. So the other country will oppose. So either wo question nahi aayega. Because there is a proper consent. There is a proper discussion. Then we are discussing mixing quota. What is mixing quota? It is a type of import restrictions that makes mandatory. See this word. Mandatory means compulsory. Mandatory for the producer to use certain proportion. This is what India is doing in many cases. Look here. Certain proportion of domestic raw material along with imported raw material and components to produce the finished goods. So what is happening? You take the case of Samsung mobile. We know that Samsung belongs to Korea. Lekin Samsung mobile India mein banata hai. You know that now Noida mein they are making it. So that time kaisa hoga? 40% problem, you know, uska jo raw material hai wo India se use karega. 60% jo hoge, that will come from Korea. That is the meaning of mixing the quota. Why we are going for mixing the quota? The reason is very clear. 100% imported on a per, I told you domestic industry will suffer. Domestic raw material supplier will suffer. Wo avoid karne ke liye, India ka bhi use karo, foreign ka bhi use karo. Pahle kaisa tha, when you are purchasing Sony TV, 100% it was imported. Now it is not like that. 60%, 70% they are making in India. Baki jo 30%, they only that is imported. You take the case of Hyundai cars, any of the imported cars, the manufacturing is happening in Chennai plant. So that is the meaning of mixing of the quota. This is very good for the country like India. Because amara bhi laborer, हमारा भी रॉ मेटीरियल यूज होगा प्लस वी आर इम्पोर्टिंग ऑल्सो सो दैट क्वालिटी विल बी बेटर 100% इम्पोर्ट होने पर अवर डोमेस्टिक इंडस्ट्री विल सफर प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट सो दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मिक्सिंग ऑफ द कोटा आई एम रिपीटिंग व्हाट इज मिक्सिंग ऑफ द कोटा मैंडेटरली हमारा लोकल प्रोडक्ट्स भी यूज करने का है प्लस इम्पोर्टेड कोटा दोनों बोथ द थिंग्स विल बी टुगेदर यूज दैट्स द मीनिंग ऑफ द टर्म मिक्सिंग कोटा द मेन पर्पस ऑफ दिस इज टू रेस्ट्रिक्ट द यूज ऑफ फॉरिन रिसोर्सेस अंडरलाइन करो उधर गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट्स टू रेस्ट्रिक्ट द यूज ऑफ फॉरिन रिसोर्सेस एवरी टाइम वी शुड नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन फॉरिनर्स यू आर वेरी वेल अवेयर दैट how Britishers were harassing us. Similar story will happen if we are too much depending upon foreigners. So, wo kam karne ke liye aur amara country self-reliant hone ke liye, government is keeping a system like this. 60% you use your local material, 40% you use imported. That is why abhi Samsung ke piche dekho, LG ke piche dekho, you know that box ke piche, Pan India. You can see that that Pan India is that only. They are making most of the products with the help of Indian raw material. Very less portion of foreign raw material is used. Whereas in the case of Dubai and all, it is not happening. Directly, Dubai is permitting. You can directly import. We don't mind. But countries like India, we are going for mixing quotas. Okay. Now, what is import licensing? Import licensing is a very effective method. It is a measure to administer and to implement the import quota. I told you government is fixing the quota. That's right. But how it will be implemented? So you can import 3 kilo of gold. वो GR आ गया. लेकिन आपको कैसा मालूम पड़ेगा? आपको 3 kilo ही allowed है. So, आपके लिए उसके लिए लाइसेंस के लिए अप्लाई करना पड़ेगा देन दे विल इश्यू द लाइसेंस फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई वॉन्ट टू इम्पोर्ट ओनली 2 kilo ऑफ गोल्ड मेरा कोटा 3 kilo है सो आई विल बी गिवन द लाइसेंस अप टू 3 kilo बट आई कैन इम्पोर्ट 2 kilo नो इश्यूज दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इम्पोर्ट यू नो लाइसेंसिंग अंडर द सिस्टम इम्पोर्टर्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू ऑब्टेन सी दिस license from government authority permitting them to import a commodity within the quota limit. Read it 10 times. So it's very clear. Importers have to get license from government. What does the license show? The license shows that you are allowed to import this much. That is, I told you, you take the case of diamond jewelry. You take the case of gold jewelers, they are all using this import licensing. Because pura gold India mein produce nahi hota hai. India is consuming gold, wo baat alag hai. We are importing gold. So wo import karke baad mein hum export bhi karte hai. So import karne ka time jeweler ko ek limit deta hai. See how you are getting the driving license. Driving license milne ke baad you can drive the vehicle. Similarly, you can import the goods after having the license. So the license is a must. That's the meaning of it. So through the import licensing, government can effectively implement the quota and keep the imports under control. Licensing is an immediate step because without license, you cannot import. So immediately your import will be controlled. So that is why licensing is very useful. But to be very frank, abhi to thoda kam hai, pehle to it was fully corrupted. Pay the money and get the license earlier. Now I told you things are slowly changing. It is not very easy to change, but things are now changing. Okay, children, now I will, as usual, I am going to share the attendance in your chat box. Later I will put it in the app so that by evening you can see that whether you are present or absent. Okay. Because app mein lene ke liye, I have to call out everybody's roll number. It will take time.